And welcome back to Flock Talk. Today I'm going to be going over my top 5 favorite perches to use for my own birds. Starting out at the bottom of the list here is a petty perch. Now this perch is made of plastic and the sides are covered in soluble granules that are supposed to help file down a bird's nails. These perches I like because the design of them ensures that the granules aren't going to be contacting the pads of the bird's feet, so none of the granules are going to get stuck causing problems, and the granules that are on the sides are also soluble, so if the birds do happen to eat them by accident, they will dissolve in their stomach. The things I don't quite like about this perch are that the connection points are very, very limited. It is just one big solid square, which can make it a little difficult to have it fit into correct cages, and it's just a little awkward to properly fit in the cage at all because the round connection is so large. On top of that, I am just not generally a fan of perches that feature this sort of granule style to keep their nails down. I do think this style is probably the best out of all the ones that are out there, but I just wish that there was a better alternative for it, so I generally just put this perch somewhere that the birds are going to be somewhat active on it, but aren't going to be spending an excessive amount of time there. Number 4 on the list is a rope perch. Now you can find these perches at just about any common pet store. They are really good for a lot of reasons, the first one being that they are very easy to find and they aren't extremely expensive. Second being that you can morph them into any shape or size that you want them to be. They come in all sorts of different thicknesses and in all sorts of different colors, which can create a lot of varied enrichment and be very good for your bird's feet. However, the reason I don't have these perches higher up on my list is because the connection point is very awkward and tends to break very easily. The twist knob style that you use to put on the cage often just strips the threads and then the perch isn't able to stay up anymore. Additionally, it's just glued into this socket, which I've had numerous times just have the glue wear out and then the end just falls off and the perch is virtually useless. So they are good, but they don't last it for an exceptional amount of time, for my birds anyways. On top of these, there also are some risks with these perches. If you have a bird that is a very heavy chewer, they will often gnaw and chew at the perches and create a lot of loose threads. This can create problems where the bird's toes can get caught in them, or they can actually ingest the fibers and cause a compaction. So while these perches can be great for creating a lot of varied perching and being able to morph and shape them into the cage the way that you want them and being able to really utilize the space, they do have some risk to go with them, so you do really have to use your own judgment with these perches and making sure that it is something that your bird isn't going to hurt themselves with. Number 3 is a plain barked manzanita perch. I love these perches for adding in the cages. They're all natural, there's nothing weird added to them. The birds can chew and shred as much as they want for these perches. It's fantastic. They've still got the bark on them so the birds can chew that off. And then the connection point is very standard and very strong. It's made of metal and it's just screws, some washers, and a little butterfly nut that you can easily twist on and adjust. The washer is wide enough to fit onto a variety of cages without being so large that it can be awkward to fit into certain areas of the cage. Manzanita in particular also tends to come in a lot of very varied sizes. So you can get really, really thin, tiny, skinny branches for really small birds like finches, as well as some thicker ones to give them a lot of variety with how wide their feet are while they're perching. It's nice and easy to be able to get a lot of depths and thicknesses with one single branch. The one thing I don't quite like about the manzanita type wood is that the bark is extremely slippery. There's not a lot of texture to it. And this can have benefits in just giving them a different texture to stand on, but it is slippery enough to be very similar to the problems you can get with a dowel perch. Being that if they are sitting on the same perch for a lot of time and it's very smooth, they can get a lot of blisters and sores on the bottoms of their feet that can cause problems. So while I do love these perches and have a plethora of them around my room here, I do not like having an excessive amount of them and would definitely ensure that there's a lot of other things for them to be perching on. Number 2 on the list is grape wood. I love grape wood. It is so bizarre, wonky, and weird. It's got all these sorts of little bulbous shapes for them to be on. Even the type with bark I find really great because even though the bark is somewhat smooth, it does still have some degree of texture to it where it's kind of a bit more rough. So it does make perching a little bit easier and does detract from some of the issues you can have from more slippery woods like manzanita. It has the same metal connections and screw bits, which makes it nice and easy to fit into a variety of cages, and has a wacky amount of texture and thicknesses and different ways you can put this in a cage because of how bulbous and wonky the shape of the wood naturally forms. The one issue I do find with this wood is because of all the crevices and knots and weird shapes, it can be a little difficult to clean. So if you have bad perching placement and your bird is constantly pooping on the perches, keeping these clean can be very difficult. Same to go with the fact that it does have a very porous bark, that can also harbor a lot of bacteria, so you do need to make sure you are disinfecting them very thoroughly. Last up on the list here at place number one, my all-time favorite perch to use is debarked manzanita. And all that means is that the piece of wood has been sandblasted to remove all the bark off of it. And while I do love having bark on my perches and think there is a lot of enrichment benefits to birds being able to strip the bark off the wood, manzanita in particular I find is better without the bark on it because it creates that really porous material for the bird to be able to grip and not have issues with the perch being too slippery, where they then create a bunch of sores on the bottom of their feet. Additionally, manzanita is always in these really strange, wacky shapes where it's got really thick parts, really thin parts, and you can get all sorts of different sizes of perches where they are small enough to be suitable for a budgie and large enough to be suitable to really fill up the space in flight aviaries. You can even find full trees of this type of wood sold online through a bunch of different online retailers. This particular wood is extremely easy to come by and quite cheap in comparison to some of the other woods that you might be looking at when buying perches. Again, it does have these same connection points with the stainless steel washers and the butterfly nut that make it nice and easy to put on, take off, clean, and move around. There's no big, awkward, clunky plastic bits that you really have to worry about. The one downfall to this wood is if you do get some of the thinner branches, they can break off quite easily because they can get so microscopically small with the thickness of the wood. However, the parts that are just slightly thicker are extremely sturdy and would be quite difficult for the average small parrot to actually break. If you had something like a sun conure and larger, you may find that they're able to break these pieces of wood off, but for the average small bird, they're not really going to be able to break through it all that much, but they will enjoy cracking and breaking some of these smaller parts, so they are still able to get some of that enrichment through chewing their perches, even though the bark isn't there. The only other downfall I've ever really had with these perches is because when the bark is removed, they are very porous, which does mean that you have to take a lot of care in making sure that you are properly disinfecting them and getting into all the little nooks and crannies. The last little detail I really love about manzanita is because of how thin it can get, it is very easy to just stick different chunks of wood on the end. I will often take chunks of solo wood and just push that softer wood through the branches so that way the birds can chew and explore, and it's something that is constantly changing that doesn't cost me a lot to do. All of these tiny little branches that stick out on the sides make it really easy to just hook different toys on to change up the cage's environment and have different toys hanging at different heights very easily. And that will do it for today's video. What are some of your guys' favorite perches to use for your birds and why? Let me know down in the comments below, and thank you guys so much for watching. I will see you all next time. Bye.